Hello and welcome to this Archer Point presentation. My name is Alex Wiley. I'm a senior pre-sales consultant here at Archer Point. I'm going to be leading you through this today. Today we're going to be looking at one of the changes in the latest wave release, which is the renaming of account schedules to financial reporting. In addition to the name changes, there's also some functional upgrades, so we're going to look at those as well. We jump into Business Central and we go to Finance. We see financial reporting now instead of account schedules. If you're newer to Business Central or you've recently downloaded a demo, you'll see that there's a good number of example reports. So this is a great way to get started with financial reporting. You can see some examples and you can copy the rows or columns and start playing around with those so that you can make them relevant to your organization. We also see that we have edit row definition. This used to be called the account schedule that used to define the lines. So this is mostly the same. We use this to define our headers and our formulas. One new area is that our totaling types now have account category. So you can define the account categories on your general ledger and you can grab that entire group totaling area. If you're coming from NAV or Navision, you'll notice that we also have cash flow and cost types. So these are upgrades that have happened in previous releases that there are other videos and Microsoft documentation on. We now call them column definitions. This was previously called column layouts. And this is also mostly the same, primarily just a name change. And so now if we look at one of our statements here, another area that we will see is when you're looking at what is now called a financial report instead of overview, we see that we have an option for show all lines. So previously when we hid lines, those were unavailable, and now we can come in and adjust this option. One other change is when we go to actually print our definition. So if we go into edit our financial statement, and say process and print. We have a new option for show empty amounts as. Instead of the blank value, you can choose to represent that as a zero or a dash. So when this prints off, you can determine how you want that to show. And that's only for blank values. That doesn't change which columns are shown if you've chosen not to show zero values. And last, we have the ability to import and export our financial reports. So this is helpful when you are trying to share between organizations or even different departments. And this is a way that you can quickly do that. You no longer have to go through and create rapid start packages to import and export those. So those are the changes in the latest wave release. As I said, most of it is a change in just the naming for some of these areas to make it a little easier for users. And since we're here, I just wanted to mention a couple other things. And one of them is, we had several questions come in with account schedules regarding to quarter, and we have a recommendation here for you can set up different column definitions. So if you want to have the heading on your columns be the actual name of the months, then you can name those and just set up multiple column definitions so that you can do your quarterly reporting. And you can do that for year and year comparison as well. And in case you missed it in previous releases, in addition to the financial reporting, There are new areas for sales, purchase, and inventory analysis. So this is a way to be able to analyze your AR, AP, and item entries to get additional reporting features that are out of the box without needing an additional reporting tool. One question we've received already about the changeover from account schedules to financial statements is where the analysis views are located. So if you have used those in the past, it's a code that allows you to switch the calculations to increase your dimension counts up to 4. However, when you open up the financial reports, the column looks like it's missing from the screen that you're used to seeing it in. However, if you go and look at the row definition and go to open full list, then you now see it here. So this is where you can now assign your analysis view. If you have any questions about this wave release functionality or anything else mentioned in this video, please reach out to us. Thank you.
Thank you for watching this ArcherPoint video. Stay in the know with the latest on Microsoft Dynamics by subscribing to our channel. You can also learn more from our blog at archerpoint.com or email info@archerpoint.com to contact us. See you in the next video.